Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel EE Lectures. The topic of this short lecture is Signals and Systems, an Introduction. In many areas of science and technology, such as circuit designing, communication engineering, process control and speech processing, etc., we are very much interested in characterizing a specific system in detail in order to understand how it will respond to various input signals. Therefore, it becomes crucial for engineers to understand the concept of signals and their interaction in the systems. Now, the first question arises into one's mind, what is a signal? Actually, the signal is one which contains information about the behavior or the nature of some physical phenomena. Mathematically, it can be represented as the function of one or more independent variables. When a signal is being the function of a single variable, it is said to be one-dimensional signal. A speech signal is an example of one-dimensional signal as its amplitude varies with time depending upon the spoken words by a person. On the other hand, if the value of signal depends on two or more variables, the signal is said to be multidimensional. An image can be considered as an example of multidimensional signal since it can be described by a function fxy, where x and y being the horizontal and vertical coordinates respectively, thus representing the two dimensions. Now, we have another question, what is a system? Actually, the system is one which manipulates one or more input signals in order to extract additional information from them, thereby yielding new signals of some desired behavior as output. For example, you may look at the voltage and current in an electrical circuit. The voltage and current in an electrical circuit are the functions of time. So these are the examples of signals. On the other hand, the electrical circuit itself is an example of a system, which in this case responds to the input voltage and current. Next thing that the engineers must understand is the system behavior under different operating conditions. Actually, without having a good understanding of the behavior of the physical system, the engineers are not supposed to design new systems or redesign the existing systems so as to improve their performances. So, the question is, what is meant by the behavior of a physical system? Actually, behavior of a physical system signifies the changes in the outputs and other internal variables in response to different inputs and initial conditions. Furthermore, the process by which one may determine how a physical system would behave under different operating conditions is known as system analysis. So, it is mandatory to study the behavior of the physical system so as to carry out the system analysis. Now, the question arises into one's mind, how can we study the behavior of a physical system? In order to study the behavior of a physical system, the engineers are required to establish the functional relationships among different variables. These relationships are generally established by a set of mathematical equations. And these mathematical equations are called the mathematical model of the physical system. For example, consider a simple circuit as illustrated in this figure. In this circuit, a battery is feeding a resistive load. We have to determine the current through the load resistor. So how can we determine the current? Owing to the Ohm's law, we can determine the current simply dividing the battery voltage by load resistance. We may write I is equal to V by R. This way, a functional relationship is established between the applied battery voltage and the current flowing through the load register. In other words, we call this functional relationship as mathematical model of this particular electrical circuit. I hope you are now able to easily describe the terms signal, system, system behavior, system analysis, and mathematical model of the system. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.